In 1979, Sam Raimi, Bruce Campbell, and others, who all together comprised a group of friends, magicians, and madmen, began a journey of years to make a movie that redefined horror as a genre for brutal, bloody, kinetic, exciting, low-budget, and truly evil movies. They made The Evil Dead. In a similar frame of mind, with a similar spirit of filmmaking, 30 years later, in 2009, Shinichi Fukuzawa finished a cinematic journey of his own that lasted 15 years. 15 years of sacrifice and hard work, completing his self-shot, self-directed, self-edited, and self-acted horror movie. Featuring gore, magnificent monsters, insanity, and brutality, this movie was not a mere imitator of Evil Dead, nor just a tribute to Evil Dead, but a spiritual relative of Evil Dead in surprising ways. Is Bloody Muscle Bodybuilder in Hell? Well, the best place to start is the plot. It's a familiar one. Man attempts to break up with his crazy girlfriend. She tries to stab him. Fails. Gets stabbed herself. Dies. Then, the man has to bury the girlfriend under the tatami mats. Yeah, well, we've all been there, right? 30 years later after this grisly occurrence, a man, nay, a bodybuilder who looks similar to the man from before, is seen pumping iron. His female friend requests that he take her and a psychic to the bodybuilder's haunted childhood home so that they can take photos of ghosts. Okay, why not? That sounds pleasant and not dangerous at all. Sure enough, it's not only dangerous, but stupid dangerous. The psychic is killed and absorbed by the deadly evil lingering in the house, and our bodybuilder finds himself in a hell unyielding. He learns from a ghostly vision of his father that only one thing can stop the dead from being evil: bodily dismemberment. From here, the woman and bodybuilder must load shotguns, swing axes, and fight for their lives as the spirit of the dead girlfriend and the body mass of the psychic unite to try and murder them to death, quite violently. Can they survive? It's a trip. Get an axe. So here we have Bloody Muscle Bodybuilder in Hell, a low-budget bloodfest that really packs a punch. It starts out fairly tame, but it gets progressively wilder as it goes. It's goofy, it's silly, but it isn't boring, and that's all someone really needs from a horror movie, in my opinion. I distinctly enjoyed this movie's soundtrack, the special effects, the monsters, and the mayhem that comes from our hero, director, producer, editor, actor Shinichi Fukuzawa, who was the bodybuilder himself in the movie, as he tries a multitude of weapons out in battling the monsters. There's even a scene that seems to be in most 80s and 90s Japanese fantasy horror sci-fi movies. One where a character suits up and shows up to beat the ever-loving crap out of the villains. I love it. I have a lot to say about this one, and I could go... Oh, what? What'd you say? This is just an Evil Dead ripoff. I mean, yeah, the plot we see here is painfully an obvious blueprint to Evil Dead. To summarize the most obvious similarities, Bloody Muscle has the same demon-filled story as Evil Dead. Many scenes are direct Japanese imitations of Evil Dead scenes. Take this one with the swing moving on its own. Familiar catchphrases can be heard, or rather, read in the subtitles.
Groovy.
There's a protagonist who's cool, or at least thinks he's cool. Just like one chainsaw-handed hero that we hail. Yeah, there's a lot on the surface here to see and criticize Bloody Muscle for, as being just merely a lazy borrower at best, or an imitator. But some will see this and say, hey, I like this. It's cheesy, but it's really just a tribute to Evil Dead. Well, what if I told you that I don't really believe either of those things? I believe Bloody Muscle, it's not just a borrower. It's not just an Evil Dead tribute. It's something else. Shinichi Fukuzawa and his movie Bloody Muscle, they're sacrificers. Why do I say this? Well, let's look at what it took to make these two movies and compare them. Bloody Muscle's production began New Year's Day in 1995. It took all of Fukuzawa's money to produce, using his savings and requiring all of his time, requiring that he quit his job. Meanwhile, in 1979, Bruce Campbell and Sam Raimi begged and borrowed to get funding to start making their movie, Evil Dead. They had actually produced a prototype movie called Within the Woods, just to prove to investors that they could make this movie, if they were given money. And they were given that money. To make their movies, both Sam Raimi and Shinichi Fukuzawa used family homes to film scenes of their movies. While Evil Dead was very limited in its sense, only using family property to create the basement scenes of Evil Dead, which were very few compared to the rest of the movie, Bloody Muscle was filmed almost entirely in Fukuzawa's parents' home, which he took over entirely and was actually going to be demolished after shooting. After funding for Evil Dead was secured, filming began in 1979, and it finished in 1980 after many hours of painful, fake, blood-soaked agony. There were numerous problems during filming, with many stories of actors and crew being exhausted, injured, and even leaving before completion of the movie had occurred. This absence of actors led to Evil Dead having to use many crew, even the director himself and his own family, to stand in and fulfill roles for reshoots. This technique of using actors or film crew to represent other actors who had left was called shimping. While Evil Dead took a year to film, Bloody Muscle took much longer, at 10 years, finishing in 2005. If you pay attention in Bloody Muscle, there are many somewhat obvious scenes where things have been inserted later or filmed later, or a stand-in has been used to fill in for what must have been an unavailable actor or an unusable original scene. And that makes sense. It's taken 10 years. I think the actors have probably moved on at some point. So already in the creation of these two movies, we see similarities. But it's not just the difficulties that were similar. Bloody Muscle also features tons of the same sort of gore, blood, handmade special effects, and low-budget wizardry that Evil Dead did too. That bizarro inventiveness that Sam Raimi implemented to achieve wild scenes in Evil Dead is also present in Bloody Muscle, and my favorite moment in Bloody Muscle would have to be when the actors pretend to be in slow motion during a pivotal axe toss scene. It's ridiculous, but it's simple and it works, and that's all that really matters. After these ordeals of shooting, Evil Dead was edited and not released until 1981, 2 years after the project had started. For Bloody Muscle, of course, there were 10 years of filming, and then, after it ended in 2005, there were 4 more years of editing, ending in 2009. So again, even editing was a long process for both movies. Fukuzawa has also admitted that he used family to review his movie, even suggesting edits that he needed to do. Upon its release, Evil Dead was almost immediately recognized as brilliant, making its budget back in ticket sales, going on to be critically raved about, spreading to theaters worldwide, and eventually winding things down with the ultimate cherry on top, having Stephen King call it one of his favorite horror movies. Finally, in 2012, Fukuzawa released Bloody Muscle. It's said that only 100 or so hard copies were made by Fukuzawa himself. Fukuzawa then sold distribution rights to foreign markets, but the movie remains relatively unknown, mostly because of the cost of advertising. It only really lives on by word of mouth. On the opposite end of success, Evil Dead exists as perhaps the most well-known cult movie on Earth, as contradictory as it sounds. But once you know it, you're a fan. As a franchise, the Evil Dead movies have a status of bridging the gap between horror fans and the rest of the world. It is, as horror fans, our ambassador to non-horror fans, our best example of what horror can be. So, it's safe to say that The Evil Dead was successful. But before all of that came the struggle, the grind. With that grind, one can know the real secret of success. That secret is, even if you struggle, even if you try as hard as you can, even if you toil, success can't escape you. What you are doing can fail. Some movies are harder to make than others. Some movie makers try harder than others. Some movies take everything you have to make, just to get halfway done. And many more that are finished never see the light of a projector, even after all that work. If you had lived in Japan in 1995, in some private secret circle of friends, you may have seen one of those movies entering our world. Maybe you were friends of a madman who quit his day job, took over his parents' home as a studio, and began working on what he thought was his calling in life, making horror movies. He sweated and he bled for it, acting in multiple roles, refilming scenes to get things just right, using all of his money and time in the burst over 10 years to finally get the thing filmed, and then more years to edit it, and then completed, finally sending it out into the world. That's how we finally got Bloody Muscle Bodybuilder in Hell, a cinematic sacrifice. Even with that sacrifice, not all movies get there, into the sphere of immortality. But that doesn't mean their journey was not as hard, nor that what they achieve is any less than what other movies have done. This space of effort, this place of possibility, is where Bloody Muscle is most like, and yet most unlike, Evil Dead. As similar as the efforts were that were put into both movies, and as similar as the problems were that arose in productions for both, the results were not alike. But this situation represents the risk and reward of the struggle to create perfectly. Bloody Muscle is not just an imitator of Evil Dead, not just a tribute, but a spiritual cousin, and a fun movie in its own right, thanks to Shinichi Fukuzawa's gore, cheeky female characters, and zany Japanese humor. Who doesn't love something as wacky as a bodybuilder beating a demon in the head with a weight? I mean, come on, it's hilarious. Fukuzawa has a clear appreciation and understanding of Evil Dead, and he sacrificed himself as tribute to that movie series to make his own movie. He may not have gotten the recognition I think he deserves 10 years ago, he might not get it today, but there's always tomorrow. So, if I've convinced you to see this movie, and you come out of it thinking, oh, that was just imitation cheese, remember, Evil Dead itself is rumored to be an imitation of Murren's 1970s movie, Equinox. Everyone starts somewhere. No ideas are truly, totally our own.
Baby.
Groovy. Now for a special treat. I managed to get an interview with Bloody Muscle creator Shinichi Fukuzawa. With the help of one of my Japanese friends as a translator, I asked Fukuzawa a series of questions and got his thoughts on Bloody Muscle, what he thinks are the best Japanese horror movies, and more information on his present and future projects that are coming up even this year. Keep in mind I've edited some answers to make more sense after translation. His responses are read by my voice actor friend, Mark Lee. Hello, I'm making a YouTube review of your movie. I would like to ask you some questions for my review. My first question is, what made you want to make a Japanese movie like Evil Dead?
Yeah. So, when I was a teenager, I was strongly influenced by watching The Evil Dead. I thought it was wonderful to be able to enjoy watching it without being cruel or gruesome. I've made a lot of similar shorts, but I decided to make a full-scale feature film because I could use it for shooting before I demolished the house on location. Also, as an actor, I always wanted to play a character like Ash in Army of Darkness.
Are you satisfied with the movie? I know that it took some time to make.
I wasn't satisfied with the finish of the film at the initial stage, and it took a lot of time because I had to remake many things from the beginning after using up my budget. Since I had to reproduce a lot of the movie, it is not perfect when I see it now, but I am satisfied. I accomplished what my idea was when the project started.
Would you be happy if Bruce Campbell was in one of your movies?
Oh, if I could work with Bruce Campbell, that would be a miracle.
Can you tell me which Japanese horror movies are the most important to see?
There are too many works to narrow down, but Ryu Kitamura's Versus, Nobuhiko Obayashi's House, oh, and my friend Junichi Yamamoto's Violator, which has only been released in Germany. Raider is a work I took in just 5 days, but it's very interesting. It'll be released in Japan this year, and I also appear a little in it.
Do you have any more plans for your movie, Bloody Muscle?
There was a plan for a sequel, but it has not been realized due to lack of budget. Actually, Bloody Muscle is still in the red because no profit has really come in from countries other than Japan. So this year, I'm planning to shoot a spin-off short film in one day, which is a later story of Hell's Bloody Muscle Builder. Originally planned as a bonus video for the American version of the DVD, but since there was no request for the video from an American distributor, it'll be screened at an event in Japan.
What else are you working on that we should know about?
I can't think of anything in particular, but my main job is for a sticker production company, and I make several movies for the company's product promotion. One of them, the short horror movie, The Complete Edition of the Dead Pond, which was shot in one day, is released on YouTube. I couldn't afford to spend most of my budget and time, and the performers were employees of the company, not professional actors, and I wasn't satisfied with the work.
Thank you. I enjoyed your movie. I will review it alongside the movie Within the Woods.
Oh, thank you for contacting me. I also watched Within the Woods a long time ago. It was a very interesting movie with a lot of original elements of The Evil Dead.
I really enjoyed talking to Fukuzawa-san, and I will say his Japanese horror recommendations are excellent, top-notch. I did the little okay sign and made the noise, so you know I really am truthfully saying those are really great recommendations. He's recommended the excellent zombie action movie Versus by Ryuhei Kitamura, which I discovered in the early 00s, and it's probably in my top 10 of horror. Most people know Hausu, but it's a solid recommendation, and if you haven't seen it, you need to see Obayashi's Hausu. I'll have to check out Violator, if I can find a copy. It seems pretty rare. I'll show this review to Fukuzawa-san. He might not understand it, but I'm sure he appreciates the effort. Hopefully I've convinced you to watch this movie, and you'll really like it, as much as I did. We viewers almost never saw Bloody Muscle, but I can say I'm happy I did. Will you join us? This has been Magnificent Monsters. Remember, life sucks, but your movies don't have to.